Where are we starting at?
I'm fixing to drop your characters into here. It should be changing your screen over now. Should have a big old black screen. Yep.
I don't know why it wouldn't let me join the game, but close my browser. That's not a good start.
Oops. Would you roll a one?
Motherfucker got two.
Do you know what the statistical probability of rolling two ones in a row is?
It was just one. The last one was my last roll last game.
Oh, okay. Okay, I have revealed a bit of area for you guys. Okay, so you guys travel through some dark woods for the longest time. You nearly get lost a few times, but the magical compass guides your way here. You come to a huge fucking mansion. The area, like, you could have swore you arrived here around midday, but it looks dark as night here. All is calm in the woods, and all you can hear are carrion birds in the sky. You come up to a gate. As you're following the path that you eventually reach up to. And as you approach, the hinges swing open on one side, giving off a slow creak. Okay, let's get the turn order on the field, huh? Going to delete the turn order here. Now we gotta add turn order. Who has the highest dex? I'm guessing, or I guess I should say the highest initiative. Marley, what's your character's initiative?
Let me look. Hang on.
It was Tyler before, but I think it's Marley now.
I've gotta turn Ryan down. I have initiative of 7.
Okay. Your turn order is now placed.
When do I go first? Oh, because Tyler's not here.
Yeah. You can also choose to forego your turn if you want to stay behind the tanks, so. Okay.
To the other screen.
Merlin.
Okay. Ryan.
Yes.
Here we go.
All right. Let me zoom in here where I can see.
Yeah, this particular map's a little smaller than some of the others, so you'll have to actually zoom in on this page. I've got mine at 100%.
I'm gonna move myself right there.
All right. Curtis? They are normal vines. Okay, on up ahead, you guys see a balcony leaning over. And you can see pillars on either side of said balcony, off in the distance, holding the balcony up. Okay, stop there. How in the hell are you in between two spaces? Make sure you're not holding Alt whenever you're moving.
Why?
Because Alt will make you go in between spaces. Okay, whenever you approach up here, you're not noticed yet, but on up here.
Ooh. I just realized I was fucking muted. I'm actually retarded.
Welcome to the world. Okay, so whenever you guys make it up here, you guys can see some stairs leading up to a door. And in front of that, from y'all's view, you can see a man standing. He's obviously some kind of knight. He's wearing some extremely fancy tabard over it and one of those big furry hats. And he's walking up towards the door, and in front of him you can see a demon guarding the door. he walks up to the door and says, "I demand entrance. You will let me into this place at once." And the demons just kind of stand there and look at him in silence. Okay, Marley, your turn to go.
Let's see, how, I want to investigate. I'm gonna kind of, hang on, I'm right here. I'm gonna move my way up to, like, right here.
From there, you'll be able to see if it will ever let me just use the thing I'm clicking on the first time. Second demon.
Oh.
Ryan?
I'm gonna move myself right there. That way, if shit goes crazy, I can get close quicker.
Okay. The knight, getting a little bit puffish, decides to take a step forward. And as he does, the demons jump forward, and they both impale him. And he dies.
Well, he didn't make it very far.
Their spears pierce through his stomach. He drops his sword to the ground, and they let his body fall as they jerk out their spears, splattering blood all across the ground, and immediately go back to their little spots.
By his armor, can we tell, like, if he's affiliated with anyone in particular?
He's definitely a knight, but you're not sure where from.
Okay. I didn't know if he might have had some kind of, like, family crest or something that would be like, oh, he's related to such and such folks back in town.
Oh, no, you definitely don't recognize his coat of arms from River's Rock. Or from, whatever the hell the other name, Loopport. Alright, Josh, it's your turn. Oh, yeah, it is your turn. Fuck. Which one? Okay. You can take a shot at him. Initiate combat. That'll hit. Whenever you do that, that initiates combat. Surprise round over. Marley, your turn.
Okay. Remind me again. Or actually, never mind. He hit the right one, didn't he?
Yep.
Yeah. The problem is I'm behind somebody.
That's fine. Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm gonna try to shoot this guy, but I'm gonna use Ensnaring Strike.
Okay.
I don't know how that works. So...
What is your save DC?
Spell DC, you mean?
Yeah.
14.
Okay, make an attack at him.
No, that doesn't work out.
Okay. You miss your attack, but if I'm not mistaken, Ensnaring Strike is something that only activates on hit, but is concentration for up to a minute.
Which means you get to try again.
Yeah, next turn. Yeah, concentration up to a minute.
Okay, cool.
Ryan, you go.
Alright, I'm gonna... Let's see, what do I want to do here? It's been so long, I've got to re-familiarize myself with my character sheet. Let's see, what is this distance here? It's a 55, but...
No, that thing's not accurate on this. You have to count the squares.
Oh. Yeah, okay. Well, in that case, I'm gonna drop an echo right beside the fucker on this square here. Why is this not letting me... What the fuck? It wasn't letting me do it. There it goes. Yeah, I'm gonna drop my echo right there.
Okay. I'm gonna drop this.
Something wrong with my fucking mouse?
As your echo for now.
Okay.
Where are you putting him?
Right there. Okay. That way I can attack, and if he tries to move, I can get opportunity attacks on him.
Okay.
And I'm gonna try and stab the bitch. Is it doing the thing on your screen, the little wave thing? Because it's not doing it on mine.
No, I'm not getting yours. Yellow one's mine.
Yellow one's Justin. I don't know what the deal with that is, but I guess it doesn't really matter. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. It's not working. Let me try cutting my mouse off and on. Maybe it's something wrong with my mouse. Yeah, it's still not doing it.
Make sure
it's fine,
your full
though.
Select on the left is set to select.
Ah, that's why.
And not pan.
I'm just fucking stupid.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Yeah, I'm gonna stab this bitch. Let me give you a roll. That is a 19 to hit.
That'll hit.
All right, damage is 10 damage.
Okay. Your Echo Knight. Are your abilities considered physical or magical attacks?
It's literally as if I made an attack, but I make it from the... It originates from its square.
Okay, and how much damage does it deal?
10. It literally just lets me make attacks from two different locations.
Alright. Curtis. That'll hit. Okay. Josh.
Well, 15 hit it.
You throwing a javelin or a crossbow or something at
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Javelin.
Yeah. 15 will hit.
Nine.
Okay. On their turn, this one is about to move. You can make an opportunity attack. No, Ryan.
Okay. That is a... That is a 12 to hit.
That's a miss.
Okay.
He takes flight. He flies over to you, Ryan.
Okay.
He is going to attack you. Get out my information on his ability. Alright. He lunges forward and attempts to bite you. And that is... Takes 6 slashing damage from his bite.
Okay.
And then he attempts to stab you with his tail. Ten physical damage. And 4 fire damage. then he takes flight up in the air. Second one flies to you, Josh. Your AC. Attack with his bite. It goes tail attack. That one does hit. That is 6 physical damage and 6 fire. Okay, so that's minus 12 total. And then he flies up into the air. This guy is going to be about 20 feet. This guy will be 25. And it is now Marley's turn. Yes.
Okay. Then I want to try the ensnaring attack again.
Okay. You want to do it on the one that's already damaged or the one that's not?
Yeah, the one that's already damaged.
Okay.
Okay, never mind.
What's your plus to hit? Go to your weapons page.
Yeah, been a minute. 13.
That'll hit.
Shit.
Roll your damage.
Okay. 7 damage.
Okay, now here's the trick with that. He's 20 feet in the air. You've ensnared him.
Mm-hmm.
His movement canceled, therefore he can't fly. He'll fall 20 feet. So, you're looking at 3. Okay. Whenever he doesn't die from the strike, but whenever he gets wrapped up, he falls to his death.
Cool. Now nice. I don't have that spell anymore, right?
You can cast it again with one of your other spell slots. Yeah. Okay, so you see him, he just gets wrapped up with thorns in the air, starts screeching, falls to the ground, and is being constricted by vines as his body is pierced and crushed on the dirt.
That bitch.
Ryan.
Hiya! Alright. So.
That thing slapped the shit out of Ryan before he died.
Oh yeah, he hurt the fuck out of me.
He got 2 crits.
I'm going to, I'm gonna Eldritch Blast this fucker.
Okay.
That is a 18 to hit.
That'll hit.
Alright, and that is a 9 damage.
Okay. You see, whenever you blast him, he turns in your direction. He looks a little more peeved than the other one did whenever you were striking him with your weapon.
Good to know.
Alright,
I can also use my movement. I'm gonna move my shade right beside him. Try and maybe lock him down.
Well, remember, he's in the air.
Oh, well, never mind then.
Statue. About 30 feet. You can get on the base of it for an extra 5 feet, though.
I'd love to see your turtle.
That is a huge fucking leap, but let me see here. 20.
I'd love to see your turtle ass flying.
Okay.
Hey, wait a minute.
You could try it. Yeah, you'll have to make an athletics check for the leap. It'll be a D20 plus athletics. It's a DC 15. Seriously? Okay, well, you climb this thing, and you jump off. You land short of your jump, and you take 3d6 falling damage. 4, 1, 5, 10 damage. Okay, Josh.
The other guy's still in the air, right?
Yep.
Alright.
Hey, Justin, just as a note, Echo's movement is fucky. They can move in any direction as long as they're within 30 feet of me.
Which means you can move up.
Yes, it can move up.
Yes. But you'll need to get closer to get up in the air with him.
Oh, okay, I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
Needs to do a wisdom save.
Wisdom save?
14.
Wisdom save 14. Hey, it's something he actually has a plus of. Hey, okay. What's your effect?
He's gonna take 13 damage and move as fast and as far away as he can.
No, he's not, because he dies.
Okay.
He falls out of the sky and flats on the ground, screeches a few times before he flats out. Whenever he does this, you see both of their bodies catch up in flame and disappear.
So we're going to go search the knight's body. Give him a proper burial.
I was just going to take his shit, but okay.
Jesus. Okay. Rude.
What?
Healing potion, 2d4 plus 2, yes.
I'm gonna do my second wind and heal. 1d10 plus level, what level am I? Okay. I'll just go ahead and give it to myself. 8:33.
After the fight, everyone gets 225 XP. Yep.
It's like 9,000, I think. Oh, is it 5,400?
Let's see. 5th edition level up chart, level 5 is 6,500.
Ow.
Okay. And how much did we get?
225 each. Okay. Whenever you go to inspect the demons, you see, you know, they're already kind of poof. They didn't leave behind any trace of themselves other than smoldering ash. However, the knight has some equipment you can steal. His armor is completely ruined because the spears went straight through it. If you wanted to, you could take his coat of arms to bring back and hopefully find out who he belonged to report it, but the only other thing of use that you'll be able to find on him is his claymore that he was carrying, and there's 20 gold on his body.
We'll just split that up between the four of us.
So 5 gold each. Okay.
I mean, since Tyler is no longer here, should we steal his money?
No. In case he gets to play again, he'll be able to bring his character.
Oh, well, that's fair. That's fair.
So you take his tavern.
Heal me for 12.
Heal you for 12?
Yeah.
Back to full.
Awesome.
Curtis, did you heal, or? Oh, okay. Did you already put it in? Okay. You didn't put it on here. What's your health at currently? Okay, you didn't put it in here. Okay. Yes. You have control over your character. Alright. You guys can make your way up to the door now. Okay. Whenever you arrive at the door, you can feel a cold presence, as if the door itself is emanating some type of just negative energy. Okay. You feel like there is definitely an ominous presence behind this door. Yeah. All right. Whenever you grab the handle and turn the knob and slightly ajar it, a cold rush of air comes out from the inside. It's not painful, but it's not comfortable either. But as it dissipates, you hear the roaring of torches on the inside. Okay, I'll take you guys up to the next chapter. Mm-hmm. Oh. You guys come into this room. Get sound playing. This, you can see the walls are lined with, wonderful masonry. There's a display table out in front there with some statues and things on it. You see there's books, scrolls of sort, a small chest, and a door straight up ahead at the end of the hall.
Search it all.
Okay, I'll let you each search a portion of this. Marley, you got the highest initiative. What part of the table do you want to...
Let me look. I gotta zoom in. What is this?
A book.
I would like the whatever. Can I get both of these? The scroll and the book, or no?
Yes.
I want the scroll and the book.
Okay, you'll go up there. Ryan?
I'll check out this shit right here.
Okay. Curtis? Last thing left for you, right? Alright. So, Marley, you go up to the book and the scroll. The scroll is a spell tome, or a spell scroll. It's a one-use scroll for the fireball spell.
Okay.
And a wand.
So, I get a fireball scroll and... What was it? A wand?
A wand, yes. And the book is a register. The book holds the names of people that were invited to a party.
Okay.
I don't know about... Oh, I told you this is going to be an interesting little play here. Are you taking the registry?
Yes, I'm taking both.
Second one, Ryan.
Think I'm going to pass up an item?
Okay. Alright, okay, the thing on the bottom, Ryan, is a doll. It's a child's toy. And the second item is a masquerade mask of a cat.
I will, do I sense anything off of these? Like, are they magical in any way, or are they mundane?
They look fairly mundane.
I'll take the mask.
Curtis, inside the chest, party loot, 50 gold. So, between the four of you?
12 apiece.
12 gold apiece for all of you. There's a magnifying glass if you want to take it. You can probably sell that back in town. And a statue, personal loot. 50 gold. Okay. So, we'll put that in party loot. Loot. Okay. And Josh. On the table, you see an amulet with three green crystals hanging off of it.
Like, is it, like, depicted of anything, or is it just, you know, something that wouldn't normally be at a jewelry store or something like that?
It's a little unusual for a jewelry store, but you can't tell if it's magical.
Well, I pocketed it.
All right. You pocket a emerald necklace. Okay. Now there's the door.
Do that, Jack.
I stole the door. Okay. Yeah, I'll go up to it. I'm a knock.
You go up to the door and you knock. As you knock, you can see that it wasn't fully shut, and it kind of creaks open. And from the door, you can get a slight view of a hallway.
I guess I'm gonna, like, peek my head through and look around the door.
Okay. As you peek your head through, you get a little bit of better view.
I'm just gonna fucking kick the door open. It's open.
That's better. Okay. You open the door. Come to a hallway here that goes out in two directions. Go ahead and let Ryan go now.
Okay.
You guys come into this hallway. It's complete, like, you can just see these webs are everywhere, as if this place hasn't been touched in a long, long time. Alright, Marley, you're a go. Unless you want a forego.
Start going down this hallway.
Okay. Start coming in this hallway. You begin smelling wonderful food off in this direction.
Hell yeah.
And you see a passageway that leads to a little door nook right here.
We're gonna go in there and it's gonna be fucking like Hannibal Lecter eating some fucking kidneys or something.
All right, Ryan.
One, two, three, four, five. Move myself right there.
From here, you can see that the hallway comes to an abrupt turn way down.
Oh god, it's shaved like a uterus.
Shaved?
We're shaped like a uterus.
Amazing. Alright. Okay. And Josh. Marley? Nope, that's far enough. Okay, as you approach this door, it's slightly cracked, and you can definitely smell that the food is coming from in here. Do you want to open it?
Yeah.
Okay, when you open the door, you kind of swing it open into this wonderful dining room, affixed with mini chairs.
Mm-hmm.
You see it's got some wonderfully prepared food, looks like it's just been cooked, sitting on the table.
Mm-hmm.
And Ryan?
All this funky shit going on over here makes me incredibly weirded out.
Oh, that's a window.
Oh. Okay, well, never mind then.
I still don't trust it.
Yeah, it's a stained glass window coming in on the table.
Well, consider me spooked fucking solid. Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna get right there.
You see the stairway coming off over here?
Mm-hmm.
And a, you kind of feel warmer as you get closer towards that direction.
We're being lured, I don't like it.
Same thing for you, Curtis. Josh? Marley, here you go.
I'm gonna get right here.
In the chair or behind it?
Behind the chair.
Okay, well, whenever you go up there, you kind of get vision into this room below.
Mm-hmm.
Down the stairs.
Mm-hmm.
And you can definitely tell that it's a...
That's a what?
A kitchen.
Can I do, like, a perception thing? How do I check for things?
Oh, and just to say, this door is open now.
Okay. I want to check for illusions? How do I do that?
You'd have to touch things.
I touch the chair.
The chair is a chair.
Misha.
Misha, sit.
Alright. I want to try to take a piece of that turkey.
Okay. See a knife next to the placemat? Grab it and you carve off a piece of turkey. It is turkey in your hand.
I want to see if it's actually real.
What, are you gonna bite it?
No.
What are you gonna do?
I wanna do a check. I don't fucking know what it's called. Have you ever done that? A perception? Illusion check? I don't know.
There's no longer I disbelieve it checks in D&D 5e. You just have to test illusions. The fact that you can touch it means it is an illusion. Unless it itself has had the illusion spell cast on it, in which case it wouldn't taste like turkey when you ate it.
Fine, I'll eat it. Fuck it.
It is the most wonderful turkey you have ever eaten in your life.
Probably people meat.
I'm gonna put the turkey in my bag. I'm taking the turkey.
The whole turkey?
I'm taking the whole goddamn turkey.
Okay, you put the whole turkey in your bag. Ryan, your turn.
Okay, alright. I'm gonna go up here.
Adding these things to my inventory makes me so happy.
Okay, that's how far I can go. Before I continue onward, can I, like, tell if anyone's in the kitchen? Or is it just empty up there?
From what you can see...
Like, do I hear anything?
You can hear mumbling.
Okay. In that case, we should probably sneak going up these stairs.
The smells of wonderfully prepared dishes is all you can get in your nose right now when you're heading into this kitchen.
I swear to God, if we just walk in here and it's just stitches.
What type of silverware does it have on the table?
It has fine silverware. It's all made of silver. Okay. Josh?
I'm gonna throw some of the silverware in my bag.
Okay. You can take 50 gold worth of silver dining set.
Alright.
Alright. Marley?
I'm gonna take like 3 plates and put them in my bag, and then I'm gonna head up over here.
Okay. Fine china. You get They're worth 1 gold apiece, so 3 gold.
I just need frisbees.
Okay. Alright, Ryan.
Alright. I'm gonna try and sneak up to this corner. And look around the corner to see who's in there.
Okay, this is where things can begin. Alright, once you poke your head around the corner.
We're stacked. That is not good.
Well, we haven't been detected yet.
You poke your head around the corner, you come to get the full view of the room, and you see a skeleton laid out on the floor.
Oh.
Right? And because it's on a lower floor, it's further away from the wall. Yeah, I actually took time to do this. I put a lot of detail into this goddamn map. Okay, now you see, unlike the rest of the rooms, this room has almost no dust in it. The rest of the rooms, you've seen spiderwebs and dust all over the fucking place. But this room is almost perfectly clean, except for these webs up here. And just below those webs, on top of this crate lid, you see a ghostly hand flailing up and down, trying to reach those cobwebs. And you hear, "Dag Nabbit."
Interesting. Okay. I'm gonna send my Echo and have it go and look on, or have it materialize above this crate. I can't see through it, but I want to see if whatever's in there might attack it.
Okay, whenever you do that, you hear a "Ah!" And let me see. Falling back from there, you see a ghostly form of a butler fall back away from the ghost as you have frightened him.
I'm assuming that's what the skeleton is.
That stands to reason. Alright, well, I'm just gonna observe from here. I don't wanna show my hand yet. I'm just gonna let my specter just stare at him for a while. See what he does. Is he reacting to it?
He's looking like he's frozen in fear right now.
I'm gonna do something stupid.
Okay.
I'm just gonna yell from where I am that I liked your turkey.
He goes, What? Who's there? Show yourself, hooligan.
Hooligan. That's funny. I just throw a plate in there.
Okay, you throw a plate and smash it. And he says, Now, that stuff is expensive. And he comes around the corner to see all of you. And he goes, "Oh!" And he would trip through this barrel, but he just kind of walks straight through it. And looks down and says, "Ugh. Oh. Hello. Are you more of Master's guest?"
Sure. Yeah, that's who we are.
Sorry about your plate.
That's quite alright. Just try not to break any more.
I'll clean it up.
But I do hate to be a bother, but could you possibly help me? Ever since I fell off of that box over there, I haven't been able to clean these webs. It confounds me. I can't seem to touch anything. Would one of you mind climbing up there and cleaning off those cobwebs? Okay, so you climb up there and clean off the webs? Okay. He thanks you profusely. He's like, "Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Master would have killed me if my kitchen would have been in a state." Oh. Well, I'll although I haven't seen him in some time. Master Arengar was always a very kind master. Surely you've heard of him.
I wanna just go ahead and get this out of the way. Do you realize that you're dead?
Silly talk, silly talk. If I was dead, how could I be talking to you now?
You see those bones? You want to know what made them bones?
What bones?
These bones, right here.
Nope, sorry, don't see any bones. Are you okay? You hit your head on the way in or something? I can help you out with that.
You can't touch anything.
Master Arengar is likely held up inside of his broom. He's a wizard, you know. He spends a lot of time studying. Well, it's in the building. I can tell you how to get there from here, though. All you have to do is go through the dining room, through the hallway that you came through, and then go through that door straight across from the entrance, head upstairs, and it's to the right or left, depending on what side you come out on. Says, well, I haven't seen anyone in some time. If you'd like, I could be your guide.
That'd be great.
I would appreciate that.
He says, wonderful, wonderful. It's been a long time since I've had some people to talk to. I haven't even seen the maids in, it feels like years. He appreciates it.
And, what the fuck is this before we leave? What is this laying here bloody?
That is a pheasant.
Okay. I couldn't tell. It almost looks like a cat.
What exactly is he doing?
The ghost?
Yeah.
He's going to follow
you. He's going to be our guide.
Tell you what the places are that you go to and things like that.
Okay. I'll come back later for the bones.
If he wasn't so useful, I would probably try and do some kind of rite to lay him to rest, but...
That's what I was thinking about. Seeing as how he's going to be a helpful character. Yeah, I'm going to leave him be. We'll get him later.
Okay. He's going to follow the party. Have him come up to the hallway. I'm gonna go ahead and reveal this side of the hall as well while we're here. Another hallway, same distance, going all the way down, and another doorway. In the same position on the opposite. Those are just big torches. Like things. Oh, you want to know what's there? He says, well, around both sides, it leads to the same thing. It's a long circular hallway that leads to the back of the building to Master's wine cellar.
About this door.
Which door?
This one here. whatever that one is.
I'm not seeing your little blip.
Yeah.
Yeah, you might want to swap your hand tool from pan to select. Talking about this one? He says, that door leads to the waiting room. It's like a little study area that we leave people whenever they're waiting to see the master.
This one?
This one here. That door leads to the ballroom. And the second story staircase.
What's in the waiting room?
Study materials. Some things to keep people's time while they're waiting. Arangar was preparing to have a trade relation with the local lords of Theranmore. He moved here from Evamaria quite a few years ago.
Do you know demons were camped out in the front yard?
Demons? Pish posh, Master would never work with demons. But why on earth would they be doing here?
What year do you think it is?
What?
What year does he think it is?
It's been some time since I've seen a calendar. I don't know. Time's been moving kind of funny for me lately.
Gee, I wonder why.
When's the last time you went to the bathroom?
Peculiar. I don't know.
Maybe because you don't have any bowels anymore.
You silly people trying to tell me I'm dead. Which door? You open
I know
this...
a way to get him to know. Just have him walk through the wall.
Whenever you crack open this door,
actually, hey Alfred, would you mind opening the door for us? Since you have, you know, hands.
Sure, rightly so. And he walks up to the door and he opens it.
Oh.
Right through.
I'm gonna follow Ghost, but.
Yeah, let's go this way first. We can always come back and loot later.
I'm gonna go ahead and reveal this entire area to time.
Some Castlevania looking shit. Never mind.
You wanna move into the room, Marley? Inside of this room is a lavish ballroom. You can search the area if you want.
Fancy digs.
Huh?
I'm gonna go look around on these tables over here. There's a lot of shit going on.
That's a pillar.
Oh. The things around the pillar, there's a lot of fancy shit going on over here.
Oh, let's go in order here. Marley, what are you wanting to go look at?
This.
Okay. disabled area, Curtis?
Like this piano and like this area.
To the stairwell? Okay, so these stairs go off in two directions. They lead upstairs. Right.
Looks like there's a chest right there.
There's a something. Ceiling. There's a ceiling light that's letting moonlight down into the room. That's lighting up these stairs. And right here is a statue of what you're assuming is Arengar, and he is holding out a book. Josh? Okay. You approach us. Alright, going in order. Marley, this little area that you've chosen to look in, here is a very complicated hourglass. You're able to simulate different types of flow of time by turning it in different directions. This is a statue of an owl. This is a piano, obviously. And over here, you'll see a potted plant of lavender, along with two rubies. There's a ruby and a topaz, and a human-faced mask.
I'm gonna another, take all that.
Another masquerade mask.
Let me empty that table.
You get a ruby and a topaz, worth 25 gold each. And the human masquerade mask.
Okay. And, can I... what happens when I play with the hourglass?
Sand kind of falls around as it would. As you turn it a little more to the side, sand begins to move slower, simulating a different speed of flow of time.
Can I do a check and see if it has some, like, spell on it?
Yeah, it is magical. You can tell just by looking at it. It glows.
I wonder if I could get it to go back in time, actually. Like, to make the building go back in time.
Nah, it's just an hourglass. Magical hourglass, but an hourglass nonetheless. It is huge. You would have to put
Curtis,
it on the cart.
I need you to carry this.
He can't carry it. It would take a few of you carrying it out to the cart and carting it back with you. But you don't have a house or put it in, so I don't know what you can do with it.
I have. Hang on, Justin. I have 5 cocaines. I could take cocaine and just power up and take it.
And break it, I'm sure.
Oh, no.
Don't worry about the hourglass.
I want the hourglass, damn it.
You can take it with you back whenever the mission's over.
Fine.
Okay, next up, Ryan, you come to this tabled area. Around this pillar is, you know, these plants. There's 3 statues. They are gigantic. These two are of soldiers, and this one up here is of an angel.
Oh, did I get that lavender plant? Because I wanted the plant, too.
Well, take the lavender plant. Add 1 lavender plant to your inventory. On this table that you're standing directly in front of, there is a quill, a demon's skull, a mortar and pestle.
Pestle.
Whatever. Over here is a small globe and a magnifying glass. Over here is a book, an amulet, and a quill and ink.
Okay. What's in this book? What is the book?
Approaching the book, you can tell that it is a book that Arengar was writing.
What is, like, if I just skim through it, what is the basic subject matter about?
Trade relations?
I'll take that, and I'll take this amulet, too.
Okay.
And I'll take the skull. I'm sure someone can find a use for that.
Okay, you'll add a demon skull, an amulet worth 20 gold, and that book on trade relations with Evimaria.
I feel like the trade relations book could be directly related to me in ways. It seems like something I should keep and look through.
Alright, and Curtis already went to his thing. Josh, that chest that you're at is full of clothes.
What kind?
It's just like party gowns and stuff. In case the guests didn't come prepared. So if you want to acquire fine clothes, you can get it from there.
Sure, why not?
So that you're not just wearing standard garb. What plant? Oh god, we're not doing this. The lavender plant does not have a name. I'm not doing this.
Yes, you are.
Technically, if it's been picked, it's probably dead.
Okay, so there's more to the room if you guys want to do another round of searching.
Yeah, sure.
I'll search this other set of... Well, actually, hold up. Well, it's Marley's first, so...
Yeah, Marley, you choose your spot first.
Is this just a chair?
It is a lectern.
Okay, I want to search between this, and the lectern and this table thing.
Okay, you can search that area. Ryan. Okay. Curtis. Where at? Oh, it's just a statue. Yeah, it's a stone book, like. Okay, so you're gonna go ahead and progress. Yeah. I'll come back to you then. Josh, you wanna search anything?
I really don't see anything else to search.
Okay.
Unless, is anybody searching this one over here? Is that in her general area?
It is, but I guess they're far enough apart that you two can share those if you want. I'll move her over to the lectern and you can search this.
Because that's the only other thing in the room, really, except for, like, that. Unless there's any particular stuff there.
This stuff has already been searched.
Yeah.
Okay, so Marley, searching the lectern, you find a book and a scroll. The book is a philosophy book, but the scroll is a speech.
A speech?
Yes.
What's it about?
As you're reading it over, you can tell that Arengar have been planning to set up these trade relations in order to develop diplomatic relations between Evimaria and Farrenmore. According to him, it was going to be the first trade relations between the two nations ever.
Huh.
Since the Great War.
Is that it?
Yeah. From that, you realize that this shit happened a long fucking time ago. Like, a long time ago.
Wait. How long?
Thousands of years ago.
Jesus Christ.
Ryan, your location?
Hmm?
A small gold statue worth 50 gold.
Nice.
and 2 gems worth 20 gold each.
Okay.
Are you going to party loot it or pocket loot it?
I'll party loot it.
Okay, so,
That's 90, 45 apiece, or 45, then split that. So it's 22 gold apiece?
Well, we can't just convert it into gold right now.
Oh, okay, I get you.
So you're looking at gold, that's 90. So you got another statue worth 50. Gold and gem times 2 worth 20. Marley, are you pocket looting or party looting the 2 gems that you found?
Enjoying Curtis.
Pocket looting.
Okay.
That's fine.
Well, sometimes you need personal money. Some of us aren't rich.
No, I have 40 gold.
And Josh. Oh, wait, no, I'm not done down here. There's also a loot at that location, Tyler.
Tyler?
Not Tyler. God damn it. Ryan. Oh. If you wanted the loot, you could take that.
I think I already have one. No, I have a horn. Never mind. Yeah, you know what? I will take it.
Okay.
I feel like I can find a use for that.
All right, and Josh. The spot that you're looking at, you find a fine comb and an emerald necklace. You gonna party or pocket loot?
Oh, party.
Okay, so... Emerald necklace. Fine comb. Okay. Now we can move on to upstairs. Since you guys are heading that way. Grab you guys. Move yon over. And this guy will follow.
I'm about to have to cut out.
About to leave?
Yeah, I gotta cut out.
You going to bed?
Yep.
Fuck. Alright, well, this will be where we'll stop.
I gotta get up at 4.
Yeah, you and Curtis. So, the next time you guys start. Hopefully we can get started on time next time, and we will get a little bit further, but this is where we'll stop. Yeah.